Hey, arts people. This video's probably been sent to me 100. I don't even know if I ever did a video on this. Now, some of you might remember if I did or didn't, but I don't know how many times I've seen it. Maybe if I do a video, people will quit sending it to me. But anyway, I don't, you know, this has some good and bad. I don't have a huge problem with this.
The horse literally comes up to the door. He wants to come on in. Hi, pumpkin. There's my niece Katie and my nephew Jesse.
Why does a horse come to the door? He wants to be with people. I mean, obviously this horse is pretty what I call sacked out or pretty well mellow. It's not reacting to the TV reflection. You got a real problem when you bring a horse in a house. You've got footing issues. You got furniture. You got things that he can get his nose caught in, his hoof caught in. You've got glass. If he accidentally touches it and breaks it, you got electrical equipment. I mean, there's a lot of problems that can come in with letting a horse in the door in the house.
Watch TV, Jess. Is that what you want to do, Pumpkin?
Oh, look at him.
Okay, the horse doesn't know what TV is, and she's just talking to it nicely, and they love their horse. And I don't have a problem with loving your horse, but I mean, if you're gonna do this, I mean, this turns out okay, so there's no problem. Had the horse gone on there and panicked, the dog barked, it backed in the TV, broke it, got electrocuted, it panicked and jumped on top of somebody or tried to run out the door and break the glass and got cut up, then everybody was saying that was really stupid to bring the horse in. But because it worked out okay, everybody's going to be saying, oh, this is really good. Why are you being mean? Not being mean, I'm just saying. You take a lot of what I consider unnecessary risks when you put a horse in a situation where you can't control or minimize the horse getting hurt. And in here, the horse can get hurt 1,000 ways, and the people can't prevent it. Now, they can expose it. They can watch it.
He's watching Friends now. Yeah.
Check out the exercise.
Don't go to the bathroom in here now, okay? Oh, you are precious. No, you can't go in the bedrooms. Oh, you're getting a treat?
Well, now we know why he wants to come in the house. If you give a horse a treat when he comes to the house, he's going to keep wanting to come in the house because he's going to associate me coming in the house with getting a treat. Now, the horse is already associating. You know, Buddy comes to me and he associates when I'm talking to him or I'm petting him or he just wants to interact. I mean, they're curious. So this horse is curious. Like I said, I don't have a huge problem with this because it turned out good and the horse seems like it handles things differently. I don't know what the first time the horse came in the house looked like. I don't know if the horse has ever turned anything over, went to the bathroom in the house, etc. But you let this horse, you know, get spooked, try to lay on the couch, and the couch breaks. And as it breaks, the spring stabs and sticks him, and he jumps up and tries to run out and, you know, tears the frame out the door. A lot of issues with this.
You find a treat? Oh, that's a good boy, Jesse. Such a good boy. There's Mama. There's Mama. And here's your brother. There's your brother, Runner. Hi, Runner, baby. Hello, Runner.
Hey, Runner, come here, Runner.
Go over there, Runner. Go see your brother and see your Mama.
I'm sure I couldn't get you to lay down in here, right?
Would he lay down?
No, he would hurt himself probably.
See, the videotape goes, will he lay down? She says, no, he would hurt himself. But in a second, they almost have the horse laying down.
Okay.
Another problem is, if he starts eating this or he grabs it, horses don't understand how, if I pull this down here and it's attached to a light way up here at the top, the light will fall and hit me in the head. And again, a horse can't see around corner. He doesn't know danger. So the horse is just exploring. When a horse explores out in the wild or in a pasture, and he spooks himself, which happens all the time, they jump. There's not nothing they can jump into. They jump in the open. They may run off. They may kick as they run off and buck, and there's no harm, no foul. But if a horse does that in a house, you got big problems.
Oh, you're so beautiful. Oh, he wants to eat that stuff over there.
No rearing.
Oh, man, I can't.
No rearing. So it tells me that she probably teaches the horse to rear by clicking and getting in his face. Now she's backing it up. Again, it didn't turn out bad, so there's really no bad issue here. Yeah, I know she's wearing pink. Somebody's going to bring it up in the comments. It's not me. It's the people that bring it up.
can't stand it.
Come on, you want to lay on the couch? Come here,
Jesse, go see your mama, honey.
Come here.
Katie just loves this horse so much. This is her favorite horse. Abigail gets neglected all the time. Brandy gets some loving, but Jesse gets loving 24/7.
Sounds like they got three horses.
Oh, Jesse, you love your mama so much.
She's a little puppy dog horse.
And again, this horse is comfortable and, you know, accepting things and having a good time, and he's loved and he's sacked out good. Is it a bad thing? Man, it depends. It always depends on the outcome.
Come on.
Come on, Jesse. Time to go out, honey. Go eat some more hay. Go eat some fruit.
How did you get yourself into this? Come on. This way.
Bye, Jess, baby. Come on. Bye, sweetheart. Come on. Oh, he doesn't want to go out.
Is he good?
Oh.
Okay, when I see a horse pawing, 9 times out of 10, he's checking for rocks and stability so he can lay down. And that's not a good sign if this horse lays down. I would be getting this horse out of here very quickly and making sure he doesn't lay down. They handle it very, what I call low-key, and almost encourage it. And luckily, the horse didn't lay down.
Jesse, you better get outside, honey. Uh-oh, Katie, what if he starts to poop?
See, Mom, or whoever videotaping, thinks when a dog scratches or sniffs, sometimes they're going to poop. Horses don't usually scratch to poop. They scratch to lay down.
Come on.
That's a good boy.
Oh, he's going to try to lay down or something. Are you kidding me?
Jesse, you better go, honey.
You cannot. You will really hurt yourself. That's the cue for him laying down.
See, they know it wants to lay down, and they're saying it's cute, and they're letting it stay there. But, man, you got to be very careful, because once he commits and dumps those haunches in and starts going down, it's hard to stop him.
Lay down. He's trying to get a treat.
Oh.
But I really think he'd hurt himself.
Yeah. Jesse, honey, you better go outside. Come on, honey.
Mm-hmm. Go on. If we didn't have the coffee table in here.
Yeah. Go on, baby. You'll get hurt.
He wants to lay down so bad. That's what he wants.
Take him outside and let him.
He wants to lay down so bad. Man, you do not want a horse laying down in a small enclosure where he can get his hoof through a TV, get it caught in a machine, get it caught under the couch. Lots of issues.
Lay down, Katie.
Okay. Yeah, Kathy, hand me those carrots.
Okay, Jesse, you're going to go outside to lay down, okay, right, honey?
They're on the floor over there.
Oh, I see.
Actually, there's a carrot over here.
Here you go.
That's what he's trying to do, is trying to lay down, because that's what they call, you know, just like a dog. Well, I don't know if dogs do that or not, but
Come on. Go on, baby. Go on outside. You're going to get a treat. Come on. Come on, Jess. Get on out of here. Honey, push him out.
This is air conditioned.
Come on. It's kind of nice now.
This glass right here, most horses can handle that. Horse has never seen his reflection. A lot of times they spook. You know, they see another horse staring at him. It scares them because they see the reflection first time. Again, this horse, you know, is it a bad thing? It's not the end of the world. These people are taking risks with this horse's safety for cuteness, and it turned out okay. If it turned out bad, wouldn't be cute, and again, the horse would end up suffering. You know, people may lose a window TV or something, but the horse would suffer a lot worse. So everybody sends me this about how bad it is and how cute it is, and everybody has different views. I guess I'm in the middle on this, and you can take it for what it is. We'll end that there.